Hi, I'm Millie from Izon Science. Today, I'll be covering an exciting new study which highlights the diagnostic potential of extracellular vesicles. The study focused on neurodegenerative disorders. These are conditions that affect the nervous system, worsen over time, and lack a clear pathophysiology, often rendering them incurable. Developing reliable and minimally invasive biomarkers is desperately needed to aid in the early diagnosis of these disorders. Doing so may enable early interventions which prevent neuronal death and disease progression. Extracellular vesicles are promising candidates for biomarkers in this context, given their accessibility and the valuable information contained in their cargo. Frontotemporal disease and amyotrophic lateral sclerosis are two neurodegenerative disorders that are incredibly difficult to diagnose early and have no curative treatments. Individuals diagnosed with FTD and ALS present with different symptoms but share common pathological traits. Both FTD and ALS are closely associated with changes relating to two key proteins, tau and TDP43, with aggregation evident in postmortem brains. Additionally, in cerebrospinal fluid, it is common to see abnormal 3R and 4R tau isoform ratios and TDP43 concentrations. Currently, accurate diagnosis relies on biopsies performed postmortem, and in some cases, genetic screening is possible. For most patients, though, diagnostic uncertainty persists, as diagnoses are based on symptom and neuropsychological screenings. This approach restricts treatment options, as patients are not able to be stratified based on their underlying pathology. Obtaining reliable biomarkers, such as EVs, is crucial for assisting with early diagnosis and disease stratification. Being able to isolate EVs through a minimally invasive blood test could be transformative for the diagnosis and treatment of these conditions. These disorders and issues were at the heart of a recent study published in Nature by the German Center for Neurodegenerative Diseases, or DZNE. The study examined a cohort of 991 individuals through a collaborative effort between the German Center and an additional Spanish cohort. The group hypothesized that due to EV involvement in transporting pathological tau and TDP43 between brain cells, these EVs could be isolated from plasma and analyzed to reveal potential biomarkers. This led to the question, could 3R-4R tau ratios and TDP43 in brain-derived plasma EVs be used as diagnostic biomarkers for FTD spectrum disorders and ALS? To test this, the DZNE research group developed a blood test that measures brain-derived 3R-4R tau ratios and TDP43 proteins. While tau and TDP43 proteins are found in the circulation, extra steps are needed to identify brain-derived forms. Brain-derived EVs, identified with the surface protein L1CAM, must first be isolated. This provides a minimally invasive window into the nervous system, which is often challenging to access. However, it is important to note that the use of L1CAM as a marker for brain-derived EVs is controversial. To isolate these EVs, the group employed Izon's qEVoriginal 70 nanometer columns alongside an automatic fraction collector. This allowed researchers to obtain purified sample volumes containing the highest EV concentrations, with minimal contamination from non-vesicular plasma proteins. These highly purified samples were then analyzed through NTA and immunoassays. EV analysis demonstrated that 3R-4R tau ratios and TDP43 exhibit unique molecular profiling, dependent on the subset of disease, making them an attractive candidate as biomarkers for FTD and ALS. For FTD, a combination of tau and TDP43 was needed not only for a diagnosis, but also to verify the specific subtype. Stratifying subtypes is important for guiding more tailored and effective treatment plans. For ALS, only TDP43 is required, and for PSP, only tau is necessary for diagnosis. This study indicates that disease stratification through minimally invasive blood tests is possible in these complex disorders. These valuable insights gained from extracellular vesicles suggest a promising path forward for diagnosis and targeted development of future therapies.